Do you need to analyze adsorbable organic halogens, also known as AOX? Do you have to screen water samples for PFAS? The newly released and validated DIN 38409-59 describes this analysis using combustion ion chromatography. This method can make your AOX and AOF determination faster and more efficient. It is also a comparatively simple method, and in this video I will show you how to use it. Let's start with the sample preparation. AOX and AOF samples are analyzed separately. For analysis of AOX components, the sample pH needs to be adjusted below 2. For the AOF analysis, the sample needs to be neutralized. This is because inorganic fluoride can adsorb to the activated carbon under acidic conditions and thus results in a too high AOF content. A specific amount of buffer solution is spiked into a sample aliquot. Measure out exactly 100 milliliters of this spiked sample. Place two activated carbon columns into the sampling cartridge. Different cartridges are used for AOX and AOF because the activated charcoal has been optimized for low blank values of the respective analyte. Once assembled, mount the cartridges in the automatic sample preparation unit. Fill the 100 milliliters of sample into the syringes and start the preconcentration process. The adsorbable organohalogens are now preconcentrated on the activated carbon. Any inorganic halogens are then rinsed out with sodium nitrate. The next step in this method is the combustion of the activated carbon. For this, transfer the content from the adsorption columns into ceramic boats for combustion. Place the ceramic boats onto the sample rack. We recommend a separate boat for each column. The boats are picked up and transferred to the sample port. From there, they are automatically moved into the oven for combustion. In the oven, the samples are pyrohydrolyzed at temperatures higher than 950 degrees. Argon is continuously flushed through the system to transfer the volatilized sample into the absorption solution. The addition of oxygen and water during combustion guarantees complete combustion of the analytes and the release of the organohalogens from the activated carbon. The released halogens are then absorbed in ultrapure water. This step is performed in the absorption module. The final step is the actual identification and quantification of the individual fractions of the adsorbable organically bound halogens. The absorption solution is automatically transferred into the IC system for analysis. There, the different halogens are separated using an anion column and quantified by suppressed conductivity detection. The AOF content, the individual fractions AOCl, AOBr, and AOI, and the sample parameter AOX are automatically calculated by the MagicNet software. This was a quick run through AOX and AOF analysis, according to the new DIN 38409-59. As you can see, it is a straightforward solution for AOX measurements and for PFAS screening. For more information, visit our website or contact one of our specialists.